In 1972, a system of externally moderated school-based assessment was introduced in Queensland to replace external examinations at the end of Year 12. The shift to school-based curriculum development and assessment distributed the responsibility for quality assurance to the system as a whole.
The Queensland Studies Authority values our partnership with schools. And once the work program is approved, that partnership is developed further when we have teachers that join our district panels. This is where they take their teacher hat off and they put their panelist hat on. And that partnership is a very important one in terms of the role of working within the system, the Queensland Studies Authority and the panelists, to look at student work, both at monitoring and verification. They bring their knowledge of what has happened in school to the panel to look at how the syllabus has been enacted, to look at the development of assessment, and more importantly, the application of the standards that have come from the syllabuses in student work.
The main benefits of school-based assessment include the fact that no matter where the students are in the state, that those teachers keeping a firm eye on the general objectives and the standards can fashion programs that suit their particular students, their tastes, the resources in the school, the special community, the resources in the community, and therefore can fashion a program and then create the assessment that's going to come naturally and validly out of that.
School-based would imply that when panelists are looking at evidence and assessment, that they would need to be flexible in their approach to that. Each school has its unique cohort and context and resources, and therefore schools will do things in particular ways. Of course, everything a school does must meet the syllabus requirements, but they also have a wide degree of flexibility.
Assessment in authority subjects is externally moderated. The Queensland Studies Authority oversees seven phases of the moderation process through state and district review panels. It operates quality assurance procedures, approval of work programs, monitoring of standards of assessment, reviewing at verification, and then confirmation of the proposed levels of achievement before the certification of results. Then the final step is random sampling of student folios after certification.
The reviewing of student work across the state in monitoring and verification meetings relies on a commitment from schools to provide teachers as panellists across Queensland. It's an immense logistical operation which requires submissions and samples to be provided to over 4,000 teachers who then meet in districts across the state to review the submissions sent by schools.
Queensland's externally moderated school-based assessment is a partnership between schools and the Queensland Studies Authority. It provides schools with flexibility in how they offer their curriculum. Teachers are responsible for the assessment of student achievement using syllabus standards descriptors to make judgments about student responses. The system uses review panels of trained teachers to undertake external moderation.